我国同马来西亚有望在接下来的几个星期推出陆路关卡的疫苗接种者旅游通道安排。是的，政府跨部门抗疫工作小组也宣布，疫苗接种者旅游通道计划将扩大到印度和印度尼西亚等多五个国家。来看记者洪宝林的报道。
从11月29号起，疫苗接种者旅游通道计划将扩大到印度和印度尼西亚。
We plan to start with 2 daily designated services between Singapore and Jakarta, and will progressively increase this to 4. Indonesia remains closed to general travel, but has started to open its borders. Since the 14th of October, Indonesia has unilaterally reopened its borders to allow visitors from 19 countries.We hope that Indonesia will likewise soon reopen its borders to travelers from Singapore.
而下个月6号起，计划将进一步扩大到中东的卡塔尔、沙特阿拉伯和阿拉伯联合酋长国。针对荷兰的感染率目前比新加坡高，并在上个周末宣布新的社交限制措施。卫生部长王以康说，工作小组认为我国无需取消同荷兰的旅游通道安排或减少名额，因为境外输入病例只占我国确诊病例的非常少数，对本地传播没有显著影响。联合领导政府跨部门抗疫工作小组的贸工部长严金勇则透露，我国同马来西亚就陆路方面制定类似疫苗接种者旅游通道安排的工作进展良好。
Singapore and Malaysia share close ties on many fronts, especially among our people. Many families have been separated from one another for a long time because of border restrictions. We hope this land link arrangement.Will allow many of them to be reunited, and they will be one of our priorities.
新传媒新闻记者洪宝玲报道。